From our vantage on the surface of the Earth, everything in the distant sky, the stars, the sun, the moon, and the planets, appear to us as dim points of light. Over the course of a day or a night, these objects appear to move together at the same rate. Because we are on the surface of the Earth, moving with the planet as it rotates on its axis, we don't feel it move. From our perspective, all of those dim objects in the sky appear to be moving around the Earth, attached to a vast sphere in which our planet is centered. This is an ancient notion and is still useful today as a model for understanding the basic positions and motions of objects in the sky. Astronomers call this primitive model the celestial sphere. In the simulation you see here, the Earth is at the center of the celestial sphere, which is indicated by a gray shading. The celestial sphere has elements that can be defined. For example, the small blue lines indicate positions on the celestial sphere which are above the north and south poles of the Earth. Appropriately enough, these are called the north and south celestial poles. You have probably heard of a star that is located in the sky very near to the north celestial pole. It is called Polaris and is often referred to as simply the North Star. If you were standing on the Earth at the North Pole, Polaris would be directly overhead. Just as the Earth has an equator, we can define the celestial equator, which is parallel to, or above, any location on Earth's equator. The white dot on the Earth in this image is a location on the surface. This simulation allows us to zoom in from this celestial sphere view to a local view that a person would have at that location. I have set the white dot to be at a latitude of 41 degrees north of the equator, which will provide us with a view as seen from a mid-latitude location in the northern hemisphere. As we zoom in, the view tilts so that a person at this location, indicated by the stick figure, is right side up in the image. Notice that the ground for this person is indicated by a green shading, which appears to extend out to the celestial sphere. The shading ends at this person's local horizon. Directions along the horizon are indicated with letters for north, east, south, and west. I can rotate the image in this simulation so that we are looking at this person from directly above, or I can rotate it so that we are looking at this person and the horizon from the side. This is called a horizon diagram. A horizon diagram allows us to depict the positions of objects as they appear in the sky from one location on the Earth. Horizon diagrams, like the ones you'll see in your lecture tutorial activities, often are oriented so that the northern horizon is on the left side of the figure. I will now rotate the image to indicate this arrangement. Note that we are viewing from an outside perspective. Directions are indicated as the person in the figure would see them. Their north is to the left on the figure. Their south is to the right, east is into the figure or screen, and west is out of the figure. It will be useful for us now to construct a horizon diagram from scratch. Here, I've drawn the outlines of a horizon diagram for a person standing in the northern hemisphere. This means that the North Star will be relatively high above the horizon. To find the northern direction, I can trace the line from the North Star down to the horizon. This is north for the person shown. South is on the opposite horizon. If this person is facing north, then to their right is east, which is into the figure on the horizon line. Note that this part of the line is indicated with a dashed gray color. West is on the opposite horizon from east, and this part of the horizon line is indicated with a darker black color. I have now added the path of a star that begins from directly east on the horizon. Over the course of the day, this star will appear to move up and towards the south. To describe its current position, note that it is still on the gray dashed line, indicating it is still seen in the eastern part of the sky. But because it is closer to the southern direction, we can say that this star is now high in the southeastern sky. Later in the day, the star will reach its highest position along the path, above the southern horizon. We would describe this position as high in the southern sky. If the star is seen as indicated here, it is on the horizon, and therefore low in the sky for the person shown. It is on the western horizon, so we would describe its position as low in the west. Let's try another example. What if the star is on the horizon between north and west? This is the northwestern direction, and because the star is not very high in the sky for this person, we would describe its position as low in the northwest. Note that this person can only see a star if it is above the horizon. Any star below the horizon isn't viewable because the surface of the Earth is in the way. This should give you enough of a starting point for understanding horizon diagrams.